Warning: always wear proper personal protective equipment when operating Appian products. If you have recently repaired a core control tool or suspect that it has a leak, you may want to perform an isolation test. Here is a list of the necessary tools and equipment needed for a successful test. Attach the core control tool that you would like to test to the liquid port of the cylinder and unscrew the side access port. Next, attach a known good micron gauge and angled fitting to the side access port of the test tool. Attach a known good vacuum hose to the vapor port of the cylinder. Then connect the other end of the hose to the port of the vacuum pump. Before moving on, ensure that the core control tool is in the fully open position. Ensure that both the liquid and vapor port valves are fully open on the cylinder. To start the test, remove one of the port caps on the vacuum pump. Then turn it on and re-tighten the port cap. Let the gauge pull down to 200 microns. Once the gauge pulls down to 200 microns, close the vapor port on the recovery cylinder. Then remove the port cap and turn off the vacuum pump. Allow the setup to rest for 15 to 20 minutes. The gauge should not rise beyond 500 microns within this time. If the gauge does not rise past 500 microns, this indicates that the swivel fitting, side port, and all the threaded fittings are properly holding a vacuum. When comparing a proper rise to a leak, a proper vacuum will have a slight rise that equalizes over time. This is opposed to a leaky tool that steadily rises back to atmosphere. Please remember that this isolation test should not be rushed. Experience and a high-resolution vacuum gauge will allow for shorter times of evaluation. If you have any questions about your core control tool isolation test, please contact Appian directly.